Hello everyone, welcome to VMware Tutorials for Beginners. This is session 21 and today we are going to start an important topic, which is VMware Virtual Networks. So I just wanted to remind about the comments and feedback. I love it. Thanks for sharing your comments and feedbacks, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you get updates every week. So I have divided this topic in four modules. So today's topic is going to be giving you an introduction of what VMware Virtual Network is, vNetwork is. There are two essential parts which you need to understand. One is virtual switch and distributed switch. Then obviously I'll cover how to add a host on a distributed switch. Also, to make you guys familiar with the terminology, I'll be using different names which people use around. One is like vSwitch or standard switch people call, so those sort of things. And again, we'll be ending this topic of virtual networks with the types of traffic which we deal in VMware. So there are different type of traffic. In a sense, we have management traffic, vMotion, FT. So those sort of things will be covered in the last session. Okay, so let's get started then. So vNetworks, which are basically two types. Virtual networks are of two types. One is standard virtual switch, which we have in VMware, which comes as a standard product with ESX host. So it covers most of the stuff which you need to do for managing your physical network to your virtual machine and backing to the port group network as well. So we can connect using the standard virtual switch. Also, as I said, this is the standard network which virtual switch comes by default with any ESX host installation. Now, the DV switch, on the other hand, which is also known as distributed virtual switch, is a little bit dependent on licensing as well. This is the way I see it, because obviously if you have an enterprise environment, then that's where you basically have enterprise level license, and distributed switch is a part of that bundle, which basically allows you to, you know, use the functionality of distributed virtual switch, which has a lot of advantages on its own, which we'll go through in detail. Okay, let's get deep dive into standard virtual switch. So as mentioned, VMware vSphere standard switch is vSwitch, which is also known as vSwitch or standard switch. It's the basic network virtualization switch which we have in VMware. Most of the features which are required to connect to the virtual machine and the communication for the virtual host or the physical cards, they are all covered by the standard virtual switch already. There is one small thing you need to keep in mind with standard virtual switch, and this is very, very important. I cannot stress this enough. As an administrator, if you are using standard virtual switches, you need to make sure the configuration is consistent across the host. What I mean by that is, of course, standard virtual switch, the naming convention itself which you use is case sensitive. This is what I have mentioned, and this diagram basically illustrates the same. So this is a cluster. You have three hosts, host 1 and 2 and 3. So you have a management network MGMT, which is named as MGMT and MGMT. That's all fine. And then we have a virtual switch for vMotion, which is named like this, vMotion, on here and here. But look at this one. The reason I have marked it red is because this is all capital here, vMotion in capital. So that basically is the unsupported configuration. What may happen is if you try to move a VM which is sitting here from host ESX 0322, it will fail, saying the back-end vMotion network is not available. So hope you understand it clearly using this diagram. And again, the same issue will happen if you're trying to move any VM from 1 or 2 to 3, because you should be able to move everything okay on these two, but obviously the moment you try to move anything from here to here, you'll get the error message. So that's why you need to it's the job of the virtual administrator to make sure the configuration is same, the naming conventions which you're using are exactly the same all across all the ESX hosts in the cluster. Okay, so let's get started with a quick demo for you guys. So we have these two hosts which are connected in this cluster, this particular cluster. And as you can see, if I click on networking, within networking, the VM kernel adapters, there are two VM kernel adapters already. So there are two different things. There's VM kernel adapters and there's physical adapters and also the port groups which make use of these virtual switches. So if you click on physical, you can see the actual physical adapters which you have here. I have given it a little bit more adapters, as you can see here, because I will be leveraging it when doing other demos. Okay, so what we are going to see today is how to create connected the host. Click on network configuration and then clicked on the VM kernel adapter and then clicked on add. As I said, we have a VM kernel adapter, we have physical network adapter, and then virtual machine port group for standard switches. So this is what we are going to select. Click next. So it's already selecting the switch which I have. This is the only switch I'm using. If you have obviously other NICs which are connected to switch 1, 2 or 3, you can use whichever switch is appropriate for you, because you might decide to have switch 3 connected to VNIC 3 and 4 maybe, which has your VLANs for all the production network. So as I was saying, the name should be consistent. So let's come up with a name. So we could say the name as VM traffic VLAN underscore 990. Make sure you copy it, because you need to be having the same name across all the ESX hosts. In the VLAN ID, obviously if your production traffic is segregated in different VLANs, then you need to put the VLAN ID as well. So as you can see, I have cleverly mentioned, this is the good practice to name the VLAN what it is. So VM traffic VLAN 990, which is VLAN ID 990, which then VMware understands this is a VLAN, and the tag for the VLAN is 990, and that's how basically you create the virtual switch for virtual machine port group for using the standard virtual switch. So click finish. You're not yet done. You need to go across all the ESX hosts and create this port group now. So I have clicked on the other host, as you can see. Click add. Click virtual machine port group for standard switch. Click next. Click next, because I'm selecting the right group. Same name and then 990, the same VLAN ID. Click next. Click finish. So because this is for the virtual machine, let's say this CentOS 02, I need to change this from the existing VLAN which is the VM is using to the new one which I have created, which is 990. So I click on networks and then I should be able to see the VM traffic VLAN 990, and then click OK. So that's all to it, folks. The last thing I want to show is, as I was mentioning about the management of VM kernel NIC, the VM kernel NIC over here is the management traffic is also always going to go through VM kernel NIC, and iSCSI is also VM kernel NIC. And you can have a dedicated switch for vMotion and fault tolerance. But what I have done in my home lab is I have leveraged the management switch and enabled vMotion traffic on the same. So this is the management traffic. All I did is edit it and enable vMotion. But I wouldn't suggest you to do that in your production environment. In your production environment, you do not want to you wouldn't want to combine the two traffic, because if you have heavy vMotions happening, your management network will get affected, and that's bad for a production environment. So you always want to have a little bit more physical NICs, and you basically pin your vMotion on different vSwitch, and then obviously use that as a dedicated vMotion for vMotion only. Okay, so that's about for the demo. What we could do is we could try and show you a migration, how it happens successfully. So let's see whether this, where this ESX, sorry, virtual machine is sat. So it's on 103 here. Click here, go to virtual machines. As you can see, CentOS O2, migrate, next, and then we are going to move it to 4, because it has shared storage and it has the exact same name, VM traffic VLAN 990, and then on the destination as well, where it is going, it has identified that it's the same traffic. It should not give any error message, and it should migrate without any problem. As you can see, it's nearly done and it's gone, it has jumped here. So that's a live demo using the port group with tagging VLAN as well. Okay, then let's get back to slides quickly. So the demo is done. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button, guys, and share it with your colleagues or friends who want to learn this technology. Reach me out on Twitter, and as always, I just want to remind you that my blog is ibrahimqureshi.com, and my new website which I am working on is AgileOps. It's a new project which I'm doing, where I'll be sharing curating content from the famous bloggers, so you can get it directly in your email. So question of the day, I have quite a few questions for you guys. If you are learning this, then and understanding, so answer in the comments below, post it in the comment below. What is the SV switch full form and DV switch full form? Also, for you guys who are already experts now, what is the management traffic used for? Can you tell me? I'm sure it's a little bit difficult to answer for beginners, but you can Google it and then find out and answer it really. So as I said, leave comments below and don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing, guys. Cheers, bye.